What's good, y'all? It's your boy Ross back at again with another video. So, I didn't watch NXT last night, but you guys had notified me and letting me know some stuff that went down on the show. And the most noticeable thing is Becky Lynch is your new women's NXT champion. That was quite surprising. I ended up checking out the match later on. And the match was pretty good, pretty solid or whatnot. But it's just, it's very interesting to see that Becky Lynch is the new NXT Women's Champion. And I felt like they were, you know, really, you know, going to push Tiffany Stratton as the, you know, the head of the division. But it's very interesting to see that they made that decision. And this is not the first time that someone from the main roster comes to NXT and wins the respective championship that they're, you know, going for. I know they have been teasing it. Tiffany Stratton pretty much, you know, going back and forth with Becky. And the fact that they actually did this, which is kind of crazy. I kind of have mixed feelings about it. It's not that it's a bad thing, but at the same time, you're trying to ultimately push newer, younger talent. And it's like, I don't know if Becky needed this. It kind of reminds me of when Charlotte went to face Rhea Ripley. I believe it was Rhea Ripley at the time. She was the NXT Women's Champion. And she decided to face her. And they had Charlotte win the Women's NXT Championship. It's one of those things where it's like, I'm not sure if it's really beneficial to the younger talent, in a sense. Imagine if, you know, granted, she was, you know, she faced Charlotte in an empty arena, because this was right when COVID had happened. So I don't know if the impact would have been as great, you know, because there weren't anybody there. But imagine if there were fans there and she did beat Charlotte to retain the NXT Women's Championship. That would have been a big moment and really could have propelled her sooner, in my opinion. But take that out of the equation. What we got here is like, they set up a match. Wasn't even at like no pay-per-view or NXT pay-per-view. They set up the match and Tiffany Stratton loses her championship. Just like that, against Becky Lynch. Now, like I said, there's ways they could have did that. I would have preferred if maybe, you know, Tiffany Stratton is a heel, maybe she cheats or something like that to win. That would have been fine if you want to protect Becky or whatnot. But at the same time, having her lose, it's just it's kind of confusing. It is, because it's like, is Becky Lynch gonna be on NXT now going forward, you know, for the foreseeable future, for a while, kind of like what Dominic does? He kind of floats between brands. And so, is she gonna be on there for a while? Is she gonna have a lengthy title reign, or is she just gonna be a transitional champion to either give it back to Tiffany Stratton or somebody else? Which kind of defeats the purpose of why would you do that. Like, I'm trying to figure out the end game here, because once again, NXT is, you know, more or less still the developmental brand, but they're trying to make it the third brand. And you want to be able to get these guys from the NXT to become, you know, main event players, or you know, mid-card to main event players, people that well, you know, individuals that people will care about on the main roster. So I get sometimes having some of the influences from the main roster come down to NXT to kind of help them out. That's cool. I'm all for that. But at the same time, it kind of defeats the purpose if you have people from the main roster taking championships from the guys and gals in NXT. And kind of the same point where people had with Dominic. A lot of people didn't feel like Dominic needed it. Granted, it kind of works a little bit more for him, in a sense, only because, you know, the faction that he's in, it kind of makes sense. And now they all have gold, so it kind of makes sense. And eventually he will drop the title to somebody in NXT. We don't know when, but it will happen. So it makes a little bit more sense with Dominic. I know some people still didn't like it. It makes a little bit more sense with him. But with Becky, it is kind of jarring to, she just comes on a random Tuesday and becomes the women's NXT champion. It's like, damn, okay. And I'm not gonna, you know, I don't wanna make this just all like a negative thing. It is cool to see Becky finally get the championship that she never was able to achieve. Out of all the four horsewomen from NXT, she was the only one that never got the NXT Women's Championship. Bayley has won one, Sasha has won one, Charlotte has won one, but Becky has never won one. So she finally won it. And you know, it's pretty cool to see. So that's a cool moment. And I get it. They're trying to make it seem like, oh, you never know what's going to happen on NXT. You got to watch it. But at the same time, does it really help Tiffany Stratton? That's the main goal. How does this help her? How does this help the NXT women's division in a sense? You know what I'm saying? How does this help the Raw women's division? Because she needs to be on Raw more than anything else. So I don't know. Yeah, it's more of a mixed bag for me personally. It's not a bad thing, but I don't see where the positives, other than maybe she can put somebody over in NXT. But once again, I don't know how long her title reign may be. And is it worth doing that, considering you need as much people you can get on Monday Night Raw for the women's division as well? So I don't know. Comment down below. Let me know how y'all feel about this. I've been seeing some mixed reactions to Becky becoming a new women's NXT champion. I've seen people that are for it. I see people that are against it. Y'all let me know how y'all feel about it. Me personally, I'm kind of on the fence. It's kind of confusing, but we'll see what they do going forward. Bye. Appreciate all love and support you guys on our channel. Road to 150K. And I'm still the undisputed YouTube wrestling champ of the world. Appreciate y'all. Kickin'. See y'all next one. Peace.